up, please. No doubt. But here, the actors are not human. They are made of bits of wood and cloth. However, these are more than inanimate dolls. Once on stage, they come alive, personifying human characters, unfolding stories that appeal to everyone's sensibilities. These are puppets, a medium for the innate expression of the rural folk. As an art form, puppets and puppetry have faithfully mirrored the social ethos since ancient times in India. In Kerala, puppetry is primarily confined to three forms: glove puppets, shadow puppets, and string puppets. Complete in all respects, the string puppet theatre has not only entertained the audience, but has also served as a vehicle of transmission of culture from one generation to another since ancient times. Historians believe that puppet theatre could have evolved much before the Natya Shastra, the authoritative treatise on Indian theatrical art, written by Bharat Muni sometime between the 2nd century BC and the 2nd century AD.
Bharat Muniyude Natyashastrathil upayogikkunna nadakam samvidhanam cheyyunna aalude peru thanne Sutradharan ennaanu. Sutradharan ennulla vaakku undaavunnathu paava kootil ninnayirikkanam ennu venam anumanikkan. Kaaranam sutram ധാര ഇതി ഇതി സൂത്രധാര എന്നാണ് ഇതിൻ്റെ റൂട്ട്. അപ്പോൾ അത് സൂത്രമാരാണോ ധരിക്കുന്നത്, അയാളാണ് സൂത്രധാരൻ. ഈ റെഫറൻസ് പാവക്കൂത്താണ് നാടകത്തിന് മുമ്പ് തന്നെ, സംസ്കൃത നാടകവേദിക്ക് തന്നെ രൂപം കൊടുക്കുന്നതിന് മുമ്പ് തന്നെ ഈ പാവക്കൂത്ത് ഭാരതത്തിൽ നിലനിന്നിരുന്നു എന്നതിൻ്റെ സൂചനയാണ് എന്ന് വേണം കരുതാൻ. പിന്നെ നമുക്ക് കിട്ടുന്ന റെഫറൻസ് ശ്രീമദ് ഭാഗവതത്തിൽ നിന്നാണ്. ശ്രീമദ് ഭാഗവതത്തിൽ ഭഗവാൻ മൂന്ന് ഗുണങ്ങൾ, സത്വരജസ്തമോ ഗുണങ്ങളാകുന്ന ചരടുകളിലൂടെയാണ്, ചരട് നിയന്ത്രിക്കുന്നതിലൂടെയാണ് ഈ ലോകത്തെ നയിക്കുന്നത് എന്ന് റെഫറൻസ് ഉണ്ട്.
A string puppet show is all about the manipulation of strings to bring to life the marionette, that is, the puppets. It is the deft hands of the puppeteers that make the puppets move around and to even gesture in perfect harmony with the dialogues. For easy movement, the marionettes are made of light materials. The trunk and the limbs are hollow and are stuffed with cotton. The legs are secured at the knee for easy movement. And the feet are complete with fingers and toes. The arm is designed to move freely at the elbow. The various parts of the body are attached to a vertical cross frame by strings. From the frame, a string each runs down to each ear of the puppet so as to control the movement of the head. From the lower end of a central bar, a string is hooked to the back of the puppet. A string each fixed at the top of the center bar and in the arms of the puppet. And strings from either end of the upper bar are anchored on the thighs. By a slight tug and pull of these strings, the puppeteers produce the required movements in the puppets. Bring about natural movements in puppets like this drummer, additional sets of strings are employed. Here, One set of strings from the shoulder of the puppet is fastened to a collar worn around the neck of the puppeteer. Another set of strings fixed to a ring worn on the head of the puppeteer run down to the marionette's head. Such string arrangements help in replicating the exact motions of each of the puppeteers in their respective puppets. Using special strings, movements in the limbs and the mouth of these beautiful animal characters are also produced to match the dialogues.
പാവകൂത്തിന്റെ വിഷയം പ്രധാനമായും പുരാണ സംബന്ധിയാണ്. ഭാഗവതം, രാമായണം, മഹാഭാരതം ഈ കഥകളാണ്. അതുകൂടാതെ മധ്യകാലഘട്ടത്തിലെ വീരകഥകൾ, വീരകഥാഗാനങ്ങളുടെ വിഷയങ്ങളും പാവകൂത്തിന് പാവക്കൂത്ത് അവതരിപ്പിക്കുന്നതിന് ഉപയോഗിക്കാറുണ്ട്. അതുപോലെ കേരളത്തിലും 14 മുതൽ 17 വരെ നൂറ്റാണ്ടിലുള്ള വടക്കൻ പാട്ടുകൾ, ഉത്തര കേരളത്തിലെ ചരിത്രവുമായി വീരന്മാരുമായി ബന്ധപ്പെട്ട കഥകൾ പാവക്കൂത്തിന് വിഷയമായിട്ടുണ്ട്.
This is one such story. The story of Aromal, the warrior. In those times, disputes between opposing parties were being settled through a fight called Angam, between two professional warriors hired by the parties in dispute. Aromal, the professional warrior, was engaged to fight Aringodar to settle a dispute. With his father's blessings, he fights and emerges victorious. But his aid in fight, Chandu, kills Aromal by deceit. Puppets are not exclusive to theatre. They have also been adapted by folk artists. For instance, this community of Velans in Kottayam district of Kerala use a variety of puppets to add a visual dimension to the songs they render. Here, the female artist balances various puppets fixed to a rod that rests on her upper lip. That is why this art form is known as Mukha Vidya, that is, face art. String puppet theater is not only about depicting the epics. It also deals with the everyday life of the ordinary villager. It is no wonder that it is a popular, meaningful, and universally entertaining artistic medium.